What's up, guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be covering some of the two coolest things ever. The coolest game and the coolest video game system, and that is Crew 2 and the PS5. So I've been tinkering with this game a little bit, and this is like the most epic thing I've ever played. And it's just the graphics in this game are so awesome. And the map is so massive, like it's almost the size of the entire United States. That's one of my favorite things about this. And then PS5, I did get this recently, and I've been also tinkering around with this. This was actually the first game I got on here, and I got my Fortnite account all set up, so we're gonna have much more high quality Fortnite videos and videos of the Crew 2. And you guys may have seen my live stream. I heard a couple of, like, I saw a couple of your comments, and I think I'm gonna be doing another live stream soon, so be looking out for that, probably around next weekend, because that was pretty fun. And that wasn't like a serious video, but I just wanted to try it out. So I'm gonna go show you guys this garage really quick, and then I'm gonna show you how awesome it is to just drive around the city. And after that, we'll do a couple races. See you there. And welcome to my dream garage here. I've got a McLaren C12 right here, my favorite car. And this car over here is a close second. I've actually had this car in real life, or my family has. And and then this is like a Indy car, one of my favorites, very expensive. And Mr. Monks and Gator Games, I actually had them customize their own car, which, by the way, the customization on this game is epic. Like, the possibility is endless. I'll actually show you guys that probably more towards the end of the video if we still have time. This is Gator Games' car right here. It's a drifter, and this is Mr. Monks's, however you say that. And then, like I said, my favorite, and I even have a monster truck, which burned literally all of my money. I think I'm gonna drive around this car a little bit, because, you know, it's just precious. And I'll see you guys down in the city. Okay, guys, welcome to the game with, like, the best graphics there is besides the Marvel Spider-Man. So here we are in this sweet McLaren. We're gonna hope we don't crash it. Been practicing driving a little bit, and not the best, but not the worst, which is pretty good. So there's like different sections of what you can do. You can do pro racing, street racing, and like free stuff. And this is free drive in like the biggest map there ever was. And these are actually other players here. Oh crap, that happened. At least it's not too damaged, and also cars do revive themselves throughout when you're playing. So back to what I was saying, I think what we're gonna do first is a neat little street race. It's gonna be a quick one, because I just wanna show you guys how it is. And I think I'm not gonna record the entire street race, but I'll just show you guys a little sneak peek of it. I'm not gonna cut out this part of the video, because I want you guys to see how you would get to this. So you have this option, and you can go over to activities. You have all of these activities. You can go over to street racing here, and you still have these. It's hypercar, drag race, drift, and street race. That's what we're gonna be doing. And let's do the Motor Trend Classic. See you guys there. Okay, guys, here we are. We have pulled up to this garage. This is how almost every race starts. Oh man, not the Aston Martin. Hold up, switch vehicle. I love this. How we can do this. So The McLaren is a hypercar, so I can't use it in this race. I guess it'd be unfair. I can see how though. But there is a hypercar race, and since that is a hypercar, we can't use it for this. But let's just go ahead and start this. This race shouldn't take long. What I like to do is boost up to the front here. This is actually the first race that I did. And also, I found by accident that it is impossible to run people over. But so that's good. No blood. Kid-friendly game. And so what I've learned is to always stay tight around the corners, and if you crash, there is no coming back from it. The one thing about this game I would change is it's like you're not allowed to exit the races. You have to go through the entire thing. But if you have a game system that runs fast enough, like I do, what I just do is I close out the game and enter it again. It only takes a couple seconds because of the loading speeds. Yeah. I think we're going to win this race, I'm pretty sure. And you can see in the top left corner my progress right there. Gosh. And also, I have a little mini map down in the corner. All those little dots, those are the other players. And this does seem a little easy. You can actually change the difficulty. And not only that, you can get more money if you have a higher difficulty. But this, I've tried the next difficulty up, and it is super hard. Like, I'm not gonna ever be able to complete that. And there's some races that you can do and earn a lot more money in the same amount of time. And that's how I got most of my money. But we're coming up near the end here. You can see we're at 84% through the race with a jacked up i8. Bumping into a lot of walls. Looks like we're playing bumper cars here. Okay, we're almost done, 95%. There's the finish. Yes. First place. We only had to reach top three. Okay guys, here we are in the pro racing section where we can do Indy races. These actually don't take near as long as the real Indy races are. But yeah, we're gonna be doing this. So let me tell you about this. It's a simple track and it just goes in a circle. Basically all you have to do is stay tight around the corners. Kind of an easy race in my opinion. But the one thing about this that's very hard is that you have to have a car like this. You have to have this car. Not necessarily this car, but an Indy car. I have souped up mine with special parts. So it's pretty fast. And oh yeah, that one more thing. You can like add parts to your cars to make them faster. Like I'm flying right now. And that does make it so much easier to get money. And parts don't actually cost money. You get parts from doing races. So like the more races you do pretty much, the better you'll do in your next race. And it's kind of weird having to slow down around these turns. This car is very good at handling, yet it's not the best. But yeah, and on my mini map, they are a lot closer, kind of worrying me. And I'm only at 28%. This is not a long just race wait, compared to some of them. This race only gets you $13,000, but like there's one race that takes 30 minutes and it gets you $200,000. I cannot actually complete that one. And like I said, I had to close out the application and re-enter it because I was like way behind and there was no coming back to it, and I did not want to sit through 30 minutes of just driving. Which is weird because I do that in free play usually. But so even if you don't complete the objective, like I'm pretty sure in this, I only have to get third place. And if I didn't, I would still get a little bit of money. Just a little bit. But, so it's not near as much. So let's say there's a race for $13,000. If you didn't hit the goal, which would be like to get third place at least, then you would get about, let's see, $3,000 if I'm doing my math correctly. So like in that $200,000 race, you'd still get quite a bit of money, just not enough for your time that you spent doing that race. And here we are at the finish, we're about to win another race. So let's see this. Maybe I should make it a little more fair for the other players. Hey guys, one more thing before we go to another race. I wanted to show you guys how you would get cars. So I am at the street racing dealership. The pro racing one is different. But so here are these cars. These are like the hypercars that cost way too much in my opinion, but they're close to the real life price. And some of these you have to, so like I'm Icon 50. If I get to Icon 1000, then I get this car. Will never happen, I can tell you that. But yeah, there's some pretty sweet cars here. $2 million, not that much. I'm joking, I can never get that much. This is actually included in that little motor pass. This is one of my favorite cars. I haven't gotten it yet. Only because I have not earned up or saved up enough of that kind of money. But if I can find it, my McLaren is a hypercar. That's why I'm able to do hypercar races, which by the way, you wouldn't be able to unless you had a hypercar. Same with the Indy race that we just did. Oh, okay, so here's my McLaren. It was like $700,000. And so here's the hypercar section. This is the drag racer. I do not like those races. They're just kind of boring. Drifter, those are awesome. And this is the street racing car. So yep, that's basically all of those. And you can actually participate in live events to get rewards. Like, let's see if I can go upstairs. Let's see. There should be, yep, this car right here. You can earn this for free actually. As you can see on the left, it says beat your rival to earn this ultimate vehicle. So what you have to do is you have to get your street racing up to 50%, and then there's like a race you can participate. And I am at 3%, so I don't think I will be getting that car anytime soon. But yeah, I'm gonna go select our next race, and I think that's gonna be the last one for this video. But remember, be keeping an eye out for my live stream, and I'm actually going to allow you guys to choose what to do. I will be keeping updated with the comments, and you guys can tell me which race I'm gonna do. And it's either gonna be today or tomorrow. But make sure you have all post notifications on so that if it does air today or next weekend, then you guys can be notified and participate in that. So I'll see you guys in our final race for this video. Okay guys, welcome to a boat race that makes you the money in this game the best. Let's just skip this cutscene right here. Okay, so basically what you have to do, this is crazy easy to do. You have to reach top three, just like most of these races, but I'm gonna show you guys how much we just like leave these guys in our dust. Okay, let's see. So I'm already in the lead. You just avoid these buoys and ramps. Ramps slow you down a lot. But yeah, this race is only a minute and a half, and you get $13,000 for each race, and you can just click retry. So you can get, if I'm doing the math right, you can get about $700,000 in, let's see, 1 hour, because that's only if you do the the next level up of hardness. I don't know how much, like, how there's so much of a jump in how hard this is, because this is, like, way too easy. But the next one I could not complete with, like, in order to still get money. And it's only a $3,000 difference, so you still get quite a bit if you're doing this one. And if you have to go on these ramps, it helps to just, like, lean the boat forward. It just makes you more aerodynamic. And look, we're already at the finish line. It's as easy as that. And I think I'm gonna wrap up this video for today. Remember, turn on all post notifications. And I'll see you if I'm doing another live stream today. And just make sure you get notified with that. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much for watching, and make sure you subscribe.